And the Oscar goes to Parasite.
'92 years of Oscar history was broken at the 2020 Oscars when the South Korean movie Parasite became the first ever foreign language to win the best film. Bon Joon-ho's Korean hit, a comedy drama Parasite, not only won the highest honor of the night, but also bagged the award for Best Original Screenplay, Best International Feature Film, and Best Director. While on the other side, our Gully Boy didn't even make it to the nominations. Why is that? The last movie which made it to the final five was Ashutosh Gowarikar's Lagaan, that too in 2001, with Mother India in 1958 and Salaam Bombay in 1989 being the other two. And since Lagaan, it's been almost 20 years that we aren't even able to reach there. So in today's video, we will talk about why India should send better films for Oscars and what are the factors which decide for a film to be considered for it. All this and much more, so keep watching this video till the end. Was it a right decision to send Gully Boy as Best International Feature Film in the Oscar? It is not like Gully Boy was a bad movie. In fact, it was one of the most loved Bollywood movies of last year. But sending it to the Oscars, when we had far more better options like Tumbad, Super Deluxe and even Son Chiraiya available in our country, was a bit absurd, or one would even say illogical. Don't you think so? So now, even though Zoya Akhtar's justification that the Academy loves stories set in the Indian slums, featuring underdogs and a crackling soundtrack, let's just say Gully Boy got its official entry in the Oscars because the director and costume designer Arjun Bhasin are Academy members. Otherwise, why one would even think about sending a movie which is largely inspired, or let's be blunt about it, a copy of a plot which was a lot like Eminem's 8 Mile. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up. Well, to tell you, it is not the first time Indian cinema has done something like this. In 2012, Barfi was the official submission at the Oscars, when we had other splendid options like Kahani, Gangs of Wasseypur and Shanghai. Barfi was blatant copy of Charlie Chaplin's film and had a similar ending of another Hollywood classic, The Notebook, which was released in 2004. So why do we send such an unoriginal films at international level? But before that, let's talk about the process of Indian films being selected for the Oscars. It's not the best film, but money plays a key role. A kind of film that can acquire a lot of money being pushed into the Oscar campaigns that will be watched by the 6,500 Academy members, and a lot of networking to grab eyeball, has Oscar potential. So the fact that Zoya Akhtar and costume designer Arjun Bhasin are Academy members increases the chances of the film over Super Deluxe and Article 15. Both were the next closest contenders. And when small budget movies couldn't make it to the entry level, well, it is mostly because of the money and network. An expensive gamble. Now it is totally up to the producers to decide whether to submit the film to the Film Federation of India. Including taxes, which is 18%, the submission fee is around a lakh. Then comes the even more expensive part, which is waging the Oscar campaign once your film becomes India's official selection. In 2017, Vetri Maran, the director of the film Visaranaj, which was listed in Film Federation of India, said that campaigning for movie was more expensive than getting it made. He explained, for campaigning, the first thing you need to do is get a PR who specializes in foreign language Oscar films. The PR charges around $15,000 for promotions till it is shortlisted. then if it is shortlisted, another $5,000. And if it is nominated, then another $5,000. The right subtitles are important and crucial.
창문 닫아.
나도 봐. 공짜로 집안에 소독도 하고.
The DCP, that is Digital Cinema Package, which is submitted, must have English subtitles. A Gujarati film, Chal Jeevi Lai, was even disqualified because of this. To qualify as an international feature, the film has to have less than 40% dialogues in English, and the rest could be a mixture of two languages. For example, Tamil and Telugu, but they should still be more than 60% of the language spoken. The film needs an official theatrical release in India. Without being released theatrically first and having a censor board certificate, the film cannot be submitted. Also, the film release date for submission changes every year, so you have to keep that in mind as well. Now, what if the film hasn't been theatrically released in India? In that case, you have to release it in LA or Los Angeles, meaning any language film from any country can be considered for Oscars if it has a formal release in LA for at least a week. This will make the film eligible for all categories except Best International Feature Film, because those films are countries' official selections. So these were the conditions required for getting listed in the Film Federation of India and thereby selected for the nominations at the Oscars. Now, after watching some of the great movies which Indian cinema produced last year, people are convinced that films like Tumbad could have done for India what Parasite did for South Korea at the Oscars. But Indian selectors had other plans. For any movie lover, it would be a delight to see Parasite win the highest honor at the Oscars. But it equally hurts when one knows that we Indians had a film which could have almost gained the same glory as Parasite, but was unjustly sidelined for Gully Boy. In 1998, when everyone felt that Satya, directed by Ram Gopal Varma, would be sent for an Oscar, the jury surprised everyone by sending Jeans, an average Tamil comedy film, to the same. Similarly, in 2006, when the question of sending nominations from India for the Oscars came up, Eklavya was nominated, ignoring all the other good movies that were released that year. Likewise, when everyone was confident that The Lunchbox, directed by Ritesh Batra, would be nominated for the Oscars in 2013, the then chairman of the jury committee, Gautam Ghosh, nominated a Gujarati film titled The Good Road. Over the years, the wrong decisions have been made, and at the time when Indian cinema is reaching various heights, somehow we are still struggling to make it big. What do you think about this? You can tell us in the comments and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you. Hello guys, the ebook for the month of December is available on our website. Get an exclusive discount of 30%. Use the code CFA30.